I'm Elisabeth Cardis. I'm an epidemiologist and I focus mainly on radiation effects. So I am the head of the Radiation Programme at ISGlobal and I'm a member of the directing and scientific committees of ISGlobal. We have a fairly large group of about 16 or 17 people. We're studying both the effects of ionizing radiation, so for example radiation that you receive from receiving a CT scan for diagnostic purposes, or a therapeutic radiation for treatment of cancer, or radiation from like that that comes from the Chernobyl and Fukushima accidents in the general environment, and as well as exposure at work, for example, in the nuclear industry. So we study ionizing radiation, all of this. We also study the effects of non-ionizing radiation, such as those that are emitted by your mobile telephones and by mobile communication devices in general. And the objective of this work is to make sure that the protection standards that we have, both for ionizing and non-ionizing radiation, are sufficient and that people do not suffer bad consequences from these exposures. So I think it's very important to establish a dialogue with the populations so that, and to basically provide them the means to know what are their exposures and what they can do to reduce them and better understand what the risks are. Because if you don't understand the risks, then basically you live in fear, in uncertainty all the time. You can't take measures, you can't take control of your life.
So the first category is the lowest.
There's several projects which we have done which have provided important information about radiation effects. One is a study of thyroid cancer following the Chernobyl accident in Belarus and in Russia. And that study has shown a very strong relationship between the dose from iodine-131 to the thyroid of the children and the risk of thyroid cancer. This was very important because before the accident, it was thought that radioactive iodine was much less carcinogenic than x-rays, external x-rays. So this is a very important study. We have also done a study on mobile telephones and brain tumor risk in adults, and we are following this up with a study in children. And that study suggested a possible increase of brain tumors for people who use telephone a lot. And we are now working on the analysis of the study of brain tumors in young people and hope to have results in a year or so to see whether or not that's important. And I think these kinds of studies have great relevance in terms of public health, because as you see around you, many children use communication devices. They use phone beside their head, but they also use tablets, telephones, computers very close to them for many hours every day. It's very important that we know whether or not this exposure may cause harm. A lot of the research we do is already global, including collaborators in many countries around the world. But I think one of the very important aspects of the merger with ISGlobal for us, for the radiation program, is the potential for translation of our results, our scientific results, into policies to better protect populations.